Hello students, welcome back to our Maths class. Today we will start our class with chapter 4, Geometry. In this chapter, we will learn about the topic similarity. Now we will see the definition of similarity. What is similarity? The definition of similarity is a quality or state of having something in common. If there is any something in common, we can say there is similarity. We will see this similarity in detail. So, two objects are said to be similar when if they both have the same shape. Okay, if they have the same shape or one has the same shape as a mirror image of the other, more preciously one can be obtained from the other by uniform scaling. Scaling means enlarging or reducing the size, possibly with additional translation, rotation and reflection with the other. But the shape matters with similarity. Okay, when two objects are said to be similar, they should have the same shape. The size doesn't matter. Okay, now I'll show you some examples of the similar figures. Okay, here in the first figure you can see the two triangles. Okay, here the shape of the two triangles are same but the size differs, so we can see there is similarity when the figures resized. Okay, if the size differs but the shape is same, we can say the two figures are similar. Here the two triangles are similar. What is the next one? Here we can see the water droplets, right? So here it is resized and reflected. That means one is the mirror image of the other. Okay, the resized one size is bigger and the other is the smaller one, but it is a reflected image. Then also we can say they have the similarity because the shape is same. What about the next one? Here you can see the pentagon. Here it is rotated, here resized and rotated. The size is different and also the position also it's rotated, but we can say these two figures are similar. Clear? So if it is resized, if it is reflected and is rotated, if it has the same shape, we can say that two figures are similar. Clear? You should know why it is useful, why similarity is useful in geometry. Okay, when two shapes are similar, then corresponding angles are equal and the lines are in proportion. It means the length of the lines are in proportion. We can say corresponding angles are equal when the shapes are equal. Okay, and the corresponding lines, that means length of the lines are in proportion. This can make a life a lot easier when solving geometrical puzzles. That means finding the unknown values or the unknown length can be made easy in similarity. Okay, that's why we are using similarity in geometry. Clear? Now we will see the concept of similarity in triangles. Okay, similarity occurs in different figures. Now for today we will see the similarity of triangles. How we can say the triangles have similarity? See, two triangles are said to be similar when they have two corresponding angles congruent. Congruent means same. When two triangles have two corresponding angles congruent and the sides proportional, we can say there occurs similarity between two triangles. See, look at this figure. There are two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle FG. Okay, so in these two triangles, look at the shapes. The shapes are same. Okay, so we can say, and also the corresponding angles are equal. See, here in the above diagram, we see that triangle EFG is an enlarged version of triangle ABC. This triangle EFG is an enlarged version. This is an enlarged version of this triangle ABC. That is, they have the same shape. The same shape of the triangle depends on the angles of the triangles. How we are getting the same shape? It depends on the angles. If the angles are equal in both the triangles, we can get the same shape. That is a fact. Okay, so what will happen? What are the angles equal here? Angle ABC. Angle ABC. This means angle B. Okay, this will be equal to angle EGF. Okay, this angle. Okay, so angle B is equal to angle
G here. What about the other angle? BAC, this angle A. That means angle A. Angle A is equal to angle E. You can see the color difference over here. So, these two angles are equal. So, what will happen to angle C and F? They will be equal. Okay, here it is mentioned the corresponding angle of the two triangles are equal. So, the area, the altitude and volume of similar triangles are in the same ratio as the ratio of the lengths of their sides. Okay, so what are the ratios of the sides? First, you have to consider the angles are equal or no. The angles are equal, then you can write the ratios of their lengths. Okay, what is the ratio of the lengths? First, write the greater length, okay, of the bigger triangle. So this one EG by AB is equal to EF by AC. EF by AC is equal to GF by BC. Okay, this common ratio is also called as the scale factor. Okay, then the symbol used to indicate similarity is this symbol. Okay, can you see here? Yes, this symbol is used to indicate the similarity. So, what is the condition for two triangles to be similar? When two triangles are said to be similar, when they have two corresponding angles congruent. Congruent means same. There should be two corresponding angles same. At least two corresponding angles same. Then the sides are proportional. The proportional sides will be proportional. The two corresponding angles should be equal and the sides should be proportional. Then we can say two triangles are similar. Clear? Now we will see what are the conditions for the similar triangles. Okay. So, if we want to say the triangle is similar, see, it should have the same shape. But not necessarily the same size. The size can differ, but the shapes should be same. If the shapes are same, no, the angles will be equal. Okay, so the corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are in the same ratio. So, what is the first condition? It should have the same shape, but not necessarily the same size. Clear? What is the second one? Corresponding angles are equal and corresponding sides are in the same ratio. It has the same ratio. How we will see this one, this triangle, the first triangle is the enlargement of the second one. See, this one is the bigger triangle and the second one is the smaller triangle from the figure. And the angle, see, the angles are same. Corresponding angles are same, so they will be having the same shape, right? Yes, so we can say these two triangles are similar, so the sides will be having the same ratio, or else we can say the sides are in same proportion. Okay, so we can write it as, where is A here? A is the corresponding side which is shared by the angle Y and Z. Okay, Y and Z. Okay, so in this triangle, it is the side P. So, what you can write, the larger one, the greater one by the smaller side. Okay, so it will be A by P. A divided by P is equal to B divided by Q. Because here B shares the angle of X and Z. Here Q shares the side of Z and X. Clear? So, what is the leftover one? This one, C and R. Which one should come on the top? C, because C is the greater length. C divided by R. Okay, so what is the ratio now? A by P is equal to B by Q is equal to C by R. Okay, so what are the conditions for two triangles to be similar? See, it should have the same shape, but not necessarily the same size. The size can differ, but the shape should be same. Clear? And the corresponding angles are equal. The corresponding angles must be equal. And the corresponding sides are in the same ratios. The ratios of the corresponding sides will be same. Clear? That is, the sides are proportional. Clear? So to test for similar triangles, okay, if we want to know whether the triangles are similar, either any of the one condition should be satisfied. What is the first condition? If two corresponding angles are equal, at least two angles, corresponding angles should be equal in two triangles, then we can say those triangles are similar. What is the second condition? Triple S, that means side condition. Okay, side similarity. If three corresponding sides are in the same ratio, all the three corresponding sides are in the same ratio, we can say the two triangles are similar. What is the third condition? Side angle side. What does it mean? At least one corresponding angle should be equal in both the triangles, and the two sides should have a proportional, or it should have the same ratio, right? Yes, ratios of two pairs of corresponding sides are equal and their included angles are equal. Okay, so what are the condition? At least AA means two corresponding angles are equal. SSS means three corresponding sides are in the same ratio. What is the third one? Side angle side. Ratios of two pairs of corresponding sides are equal and their included angles are equal. So either one condition, if the two triangles has, we can say that those two triangles have similarity in between them. Clear?
Now let's see all the three conditions separately in detail. What is the first one? Angle-angle similarity. In this, in two triangles, if two pairs of corresponding angles are congruent, then the triangles are similar. See, here in this two triangles, look at this picture. In this two triangles, which angles are equal? There are two angles. See, this one with single arc. Okay, with single arc, this angle A is congruent. Congruent means same as angle P. What about the second angle with two arcs, right? This two arcs, here two arcs. That means angle B is equal to angle Q. Okay, so in the above figure, since angle A is congruent, this is the symbol used to represent the congruency. So angle A is congruent to angle P and angle B is congruent to angle Q. Then by AA similarity, we can say these two triangles are similar. Clear? This is a symbol used to represent the similarity. Clear? So we can say if two corresponding angles are congruent, then the two triangles are similar. This is the condition of AA similarity or else angle-angle similarity. Now we will see the second condition in detail. What is the second condition? SSS similarity. It means side similarity for triangles, right? If all three pairs of corresponding sides of two triangles are proportional, then the triangles are said to be similar. You can see from the figure, there are two triangles, right? What are the two triangles here? ABC and triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. Okay, here ABC is a smaller triangle and XYZ is the bigger one. Okay, in these two triangles, the all three pairs of corresponding sides are proportional. Okay, which are the sides are proportional? See the pink side. AB is proportional with YZ. That means YZ by AB. The bigger one by the smaller one. What is the next one? XY. XY, the green line represents here and here AC. This means they two are proportional. It means XY by AC is equal to what is the leftover? This blue line. XZ by BC. So we can write if YZ by AB is equal to XC or XZ by BC is equal to XY by AC, then we can say these two triangles are similar by representing with this symbol. This is the symbol for similarity. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle XYZ. Now we will see the third similarity condition. Okay, what is that? SAS similarity. It means side angle, side similarity. Here see, if two sides in one triangle are proportional, if two sides in one triangle are proportional to two sides in another triangle, this two sides in one triangle is proportional to two sides in another triangle, and the included angle means, see, listen, included angle means the angle which lies between the sides which are proportional, okay, these two sides, this angle and this angle, okay, or congruent. Congruent means they are same, okay. If these two angles, angle A is congruent to angle X and the two sides are proportional, then we can say that two triangles are similar. Okay, then we can say these two triangles are similar. That means if AB by, see, AB, this side AB, this green line, okay, this AB by XY is equal to AC by XZ. Okay, if these two sides are proportional and the angles included by these two sides, which is the angle the, that is congruent, that is angle A is congruent to angle X, then we can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle XYZ. This is a condition of SAS similarity. Okay, what is SAS similarity? If two sides in one triangle are proportional to two sides in another triangle and the included angle in both are congruent. Included angle means the angle which lies between these two lines, okay, are congruent, then we can say the two triangles are similar. This is the third condition for similarity. So in general, we can say two triangles are similar if the only difference is the size. If the triangles differ only in the size, but it is same in the shape, you can say that triangles are all similar. Here the few examples of the triangles with the single arc angles all same in the all the five triangles, and the double arc means all the angles are congruent in all the triangles, and the triple arc means all the triple arc angles are congruent in all the five triangles. It means all the five triangles are all similar. Okay, triangles are similar, different in size and rotations. Either it can be rotated or flipped. Okay, in either directions it can be similar. Equal angles have been marked with the same number of arcs. You can see it clearly. See, you can see this angles. Single arc means if it is represented by single arc in both the triangles, it means both the angles are congruent, okay, in the two triangles. And the double arc means this double arc and here this double arc angles are congruent in both the triangles. And the triple arc means these two angles are congruent. Equal angles have been marked with the same number of arcs, okay. Then some of them have different sizes and some of them have been turned or flipped. There can be difference in sizes, they can be turned or flipped, okay, for similar triangles. Okay, these are the condition and the same share the same ratios of sides. Okay, corresponding angles on two triangles are equal or congruent, or else all corresponding sides have the same ratio, they will share the same ratio. These are the conditions for the triangles to be similar. Clear? In similar triangles, you should know what are the corresponding sides and how you can understand the corresponding sides. Okay, so with an example, I'll explain you. These two are the triangles, two triangles, triangle R and S are the triangles given for your understanding. Okay, see, in similar triangles, corresponding sides are always in the same ratio. Okay, what it is, we will see. These are the two triangles. See, triangle R and triangle S. Okay, here these two triangles are given with the sides. Okay, the triangle R and S are similar. Here it is mentioned these two triangles are similar. Okay, the equal angles are marked with the same number of arcs. Equal angles are marked with same number of arcs. The single line R means these two angles are equal or congruent. Okay, then this double arc is equal to this double arc angle. What about this triple arc? this one, three lines, arcs with three lines, these two are equal. Okay, so what are the corresponding lengths? How we can understand about the corresponding lengths? What it means about corresponding lengths? The length 7 in triangle R. Okay, and length A, this will be corresponding side of which one? Because 7 shares the angle of double R and triple R. So where does it lies? It will be corresponding to this side A, right? Yes, see, the length 7 and A are corresponding sides. Okay, they face the angle marked with 1R. They face the angle marked with, because this side is opposite to the angle of 1R. Clear? Yes, they face the angle marked with 1R, or else we can say they share the angle of double R and triple R. Okay. Then what about the next one? The lengths 8 and 6.4 are corresponding. Length 8 and 6.4, we can say they are corresponding because they face the angle marked with 2R. It lies just opposite. It faces the angle marked with 2R. Here also 8 faces the angle marked with 2R. Okay. The length 6 and B. What about 6 and B? 6 and this B. Okay, 6 and this B, okay, are corresponding because they face the angle marked with 3R. They face the angle marked with 3R. It lies just opposite to this angle 3R, marked with 3R. Okay, so these two are corresponding sides. Now you will be clear with the concept of corresponding sides. So the 7 corresponding side with the triangle S is the side A. What about this 8? For 8, the corresponding side will be 6.4, right? What about this 6? This corresponding side will be B. Clear? So these are this is the way how you should match the corresponding sides of the two triangles. Clear? Now see, using the concept of the similarity of the triangles, we can calculate the length of the corresponding side. Okay, using the concepts what and all we saw in the previous section, we can use those concepts in calculating the length of corresponding sides. We can sometimes calculate lengths we don't know. If it is not mentioned, we can calculate those lengths by using the ratios of corresponding sides. For what is the first step? There are two steps. First one is find the ratios of corresponding sides. Okay, you have to find the ratios of corresponding sides. Then step 2, use that ratio to find the unknown lengths. Using that ratio, you can find the unknown lengths. Okay, so using the concept of similarity of the two triangles, we can find the unknown lengths given in the triangle. Okay. Now we'll see how to calculate the lengths of the corresponding sides. Okay, with that example. Example, find lengths A and B of triangle S. Triangle similar to triangle R. Okay, these two triangles are given, triangle R and S. It is mentioned that these two triangles are similar. Okay, what about the sides? Sides are given, all the three sides are given for R, triangle R. What about triangle S? Here A and B is not mentioned. Okay, you have to find the lengths of A and B using the concept of similarity. What is the first step? There are two steps. First, you have to find the ratio of the corresponding side. What is the next step? Using that ratio, you have to find the value of unknown lengths. Okay, so we will see how we can find the unknown lengths. Okay, see, what is the first step? See, find the ratio. First, you should know which are the corresponding sides. With that previous example I have given you, know the two triangles, that same example I have taken to calculate the length so that it will be easy for you. We know all the sides in triangle R. See, all the sides of this triangle R is given. Okay, but we don't know about A and B. Only 6.4, the side 6.4 is given in triangle S. Okay, the 6.4 faces the angle marked with 2R. This 6.4 faces the angle with double R or 2R. So this will be the corresponding side of which side? This one, 8, because 8 faces the 2R angle. Clear? So 8 will be proportional to 6.4. Clear? So we can match 8 with 6.4. And so the ratio of sides in triangle S to triangle R we can write, okay, or else R with S. Better consider this bigger triangle with a smaller one. It will be easy for your understanding. So what I am doing now, the corresponding sides I am writing as 8 by 6.4. Okay, corresponding side, the ratios of corresponding side. 8 by 6.4 is equal to 6. What about the 6? 6 faces the triple arc angle. Okay, 3 line angle. So, it will be corresponding side of this one, B. Okay, so 6 by B is equal to 7 by A. Clear? Because this 7 faces the single arc angle and also this A faces the single arc angle. So, 7 by A. Now, you got the corresponding sides ratio. Okay. 8 by 6.4 is equal to 6 by B is equal to 7 by A. Using this ratio, you have to calculate the unknown. Here in this three ratios, there are three ratios in this known. Which one has the known value? 8 by 6.4, we know the, we have the known values. Other two are unknown value. Okay, so compare this known value with one unknown value and find the other unknown. Then, compare again, you compare the known ratio with the unknown and then find the other unknown. Clear? See this step. Step 2, using the ratio. A faces the angle with one arc as does the side of 7 in triangle R, that you know clearly. So, with the, what is the known ratio here? 8 by 6.4. Write this one. This will be equated to the next one. First, we will find A. Okay, 7 by A. 8 by 6.4 is equal to 7 by A. Or else, you can compare with 6 by B. But now, I am finding A first. Okay, so 8 by 6.4 is the known ratio. I am comparing with 7 by A. Okay, so then after comparing these two ratio, what I am doing, you have to cross multiply. See, 8 multiplied A. A goes this side and 6.4 with the 7. Okay, what will happen? A is equal to 6.4 by 8 multiply 7. This gives the value of 5.6. How you can find this B? Again, compare the known ratio with this B ratio. Okay, so 8 by 6.4 is equal to 6 by B. Again, if you cross multiply these two ratios, you can find the value of B. B will be 4.8. This is a way how you can find the corresponding lengths, unknown values, using the concept of similarity of two triangles. First, what is the first step? First, you have to check the corresponding angles. Then you have to find the corresponding ratios of the sides. Okay. Then compare the known ratio with the unknown ratio. Then find the unknown lengths of the two triangles. Clear? Now we will move on to exercise 7, question number 1. What is the question given? Find the sides marked with letters. All lengths are given in centimeters. Here the two triangles given. Okay. So from the picture you can see there are two triangles with sides mentioned. Okay. They are asked you to find the unknown lengths. Okay. Here triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Angle B is congruent. And the angle C, look at the picture. You can see it clearly. This angle B is congruent with angle E. And also angle C is congruent with angle F. Okay, so the corresponding sides will be proportional. You have to check for the corresponding sides. Okay, what is the corresponding sign? First, the with the bigger value we will start. So DE by AB is equal to DF by AC. Okay, is equal to EF by BC. So what is the value of DE? You have to check. What is the value? DE is 5. So 5 by A is equal to 4 by 2 is equal to 6 by E. This is the corresponding proportional of corresponding sides. Okay. So now there are three ratios. Okay. Now three ratios we have. Compare the first and second ratio, because second ratio is the known value and the first and third has the unknown value. So compare first and second ratio. See, comparing first and second ratio, you can calculate the value of A by cross multiplication. Clear? So what is the value of A? A will be 2.5. Here all the lengths are in centimeter, so it will be 2.5 centimeter. Comparing second and third ratio, it will be 4/2 = 6/e. Again, now cross multiplying, you will be getting the value of E. What is the value? It will be 3 centimeter. Okay, so whenever you are asked to find the unknown length for the similar triangles, first you have to check for the congruent angles, then you have to write the proportional sides. Okay, then you have to compare the known values with the unknown values in the ratios, then you have to calculate the unknown lengths. Clear? Yes. We will move on to our assignment part. What is the assignment for today? From exercise 7, question number 3, question number 5, 8 and 10. In these questions, you have to compare the two triangles, find out the corresponding ratios and compare the known ratio with the unknown ratio and find the value of the unknown lengths. Okay, keep it ready. Let's check in the next video. Bye for now.